Welcome back to the annual meeting of the Asian Development Bank in Nandi, Fiji. I'm here today with Ms. Premila Kumar, who is the Minister for Trade, Industry and Tourism of host country Fiji. Minister, one of the major topics of discussion here at the event has been the development of the so-called blue economy, which features sectors like fisheries, sustainable tourism and waste management, for example. Fiji can clearly become a champion, a global champion of the blue economy, but still questions remain over on the overall financial sustainability of this approach. Do you believe that the blue economy can be as a whole bankable, and what are the possible opportunities in blue economy sectors for investors interested in Fiji?
Looking at Fiji, we are a small island state. And we can say we are a small island state, but we are very big in terms of ocean. We can call ourselves the largest ocean nation in the world, where we have got a lot more water around us than the land. And we believe that we can capitalize on the ocean in developing our economy, in building our capacity to deal with the oceans. We have found that over the years, there has been a lot more discussion in terms of how the economic growth can take place on the land. So it was all land-based, but somehow or the other, very little focus was on the ocean. And as we see, there is a lot of development going on in the world, and there is a lot of pollution, land-based pollution, etc. At the end of the day, it's the ocean that suffers. We've got a lot of marine resources that we depend on. So from the Fiji's perspective, because we've got a very vast ocean, we've got a lot of marine life, and you may have seen some of the beautiful marine life that we have. And we believe that if we can control waste management, pollution control from the land-based sources into the ocean, we'll be able to develop our marine resources in a much better way. And we can capitalize on it, and we can grow our economy. And that's something that we have to realize, that there is lot of potential there.
Fiji is also in the process of upgrading its laws and legislation to improve its business, the country's business and investment environment. Do you want to give us some more insights into what we can expect in this direction?
When you look at the economic growth of Fiji, we've been doing extremely well for the last 10 years. As you know, with the global financial crisis, number of countries went into deep financial troubles. But for Fiji's case, our economic growth, despite major cyclones, we've been doing well. Our tourism sector is about 38% of our GDP. And if you look at the private investment towards our economic growth, we see that it's only 15%. We would like to increase that further. And for us to do that, we need to attract more foreign direct investment. And to get foreign investors into the country, we have to create the best enabling environment. And for the best enabling environment, the number of things that we have already started doing. For example, we would like to develop this special economic zone, play and plug mechanism, where the investors just come in without any headache, can start their business because there is electricity, there is all other infrastructure created for them.
Any particular zone in manufacturing services, what would be the target of these zones?
This zone would be more on manufacturing. We would like to increase our manufacturing base. At the moment, manufacturing base is just about 15%, so we'd like to increase that further. And whereas our service sector is about 70%.
Manufacturing for the domestic market or global, to be part of global?
When we look at our industries, it's just about 15%. So we would like to, first of all, as an island country, trade is very important for us because there are a lot of things that we don't produce. We depend on international market for those goods and services. Wherever we can produce surplus, this is where we look for the international market. And there are many areas where we think we are doing very good and we can capitalize on it.
Such as?
Garment factory is one. Then we have got water bottling is another one. Then we also produce our own beauty products called Piwa Fiji. We can send it to the spa market abroad. So there are opportunities there. So for the enabling environment, we are working on our Foreign Investment Act. We would like to make it more flexible, where we can attract more knowledge-based industries, more of these business process outsourcing type of industries into our country. So we are looking at efficiency-seeking industries that can come into the country and they can set up this business. But along with that, we are also reforming our, we have already reformed our tax sector. So now for any businesses, the tax is only 20%. So we are doing well from that perspective, that we are trying to be competitive. We compete with the rest of the world in that area. But we do realize that one area that we seriously need to look at is the capacity building because of the new technologies that's coming into the country. So we need to upskill our workers, and that's an ongoing activity with various universities that we have in Fiji. So they are actually assisting us in developing the right minds, the right hands to do the job.
Premila Kumar, Minister of Trade, Industry and Tourism of Fiji, thanks for your comments. Thanks everybody for watching. You can follow all our coverage of the annual meeting of the Asian Development Bank on our websites, fdiintelligence.com and thebanker.com.